Hello everyone, welcome once again to Investing with a Difference. I hope everybody had a great holiday season. Happy New Year, first of all. Before we start, and definitely today we are going to cover what we learned in the last 1 year, what's happening, a quick summary of what I believe has been going around. And in the process, I think while we were away, while we were taking a break, I did think about how far we have come, what's going on with Investing with a Difference. And I would like to start with that first of all. And then, of course, we will be sharing a lot more details. So as I said, it looks like a pretty big year, 2018, in Investing with a Difference as YouTube channel, as this community. This was not there when we started. So Investing with a Difference was kind of a small group. I was running with a lot of investor friends. And what happened, this was pretty much unexpected. So for me, when I look back, I'm, as most of you who know me, you know that I'm not a YouTuber. I'm not into these things. It was just created based on what community asked for, and I never expected. If you had told me at the start of 2018 that we will have 4,000 plus subscribers and I will do so many videos on YouTube, I would have not believed it. But anyway, we are here. We had been creating this dialogues over Twitter, Telegram. We had started Twitter updates. So all this is thanks for all your love. First of all, thanks a lot. But again, as I keep reminding myself, I'm not a YouTuber. This was never my goal. I love EOS because I came into this as an investor, as a person who supports startups, who have been working with a lot of startups in before blockchain, before Bitcoin, before EOS. And this is something which is like, I always look for new technologies. I always look for what's going on. And EOS is something which I'm very passionate about. 2018 gave me this new passion. And that's why we are here in this Investing with a Difference. So why I'm saying all this? Because while I was away, I was thinking about what we are going to do with this channel. And I just thought to myself, I think when I started this, there was a lack of EOS content. We started before Mainnet launch. We were doing a lot of EOS specific videos to learn what's going on at Mainnet launch. We went through a very, very difficult phase when information was difficult to get. People were still on Ethereum wallets, transferring into EOS. Then we kept on creating content. Now, the good thing is EOS is a huge ecosystem. We have a lot of good YouTubers, a lot of good content being created. So now I don't see a need for us to be creating tutorials for EOS, how to do this, how to do that. I keep getting this request, so just wanted to update all the viewers here. The difference we wanted to bring is I'm not somebody who can do great content for you, to tutorials in terms of what are the very basic information. And there is no lack of that content anymore. So what I'm going to focus on is my views on what's happening in EOS world, what's happening as an investment world, and then as I, my best capabilities, the use of my capabilities is when I go and start building EOS. As I explained in previous videos and previous, I think if you're following me, we are going to do a lot more dApp work within Investing with a Difference. Now we call it Blockstart. That's our new initiative, and we will keep sharing more details on that. Now, having said that, of course, as I promised to you, we will keep bringing a lot of content to you. It will be all about how to think about the markets, how to think about the ecosystem, what are the opportunities out there. And as an investor, we will always be talking to you as how you can make real progress in making money in terms of taking advantage of the opportunities and what's the best places to look at. So first of all, let's start with the overall market and the views. So what's happening here? We saw the $3,000 mark towards end of the year. We are seeing some great, I think, up moves. We are seeing some big moves in Ethereum. It has gone up pretty significantly, outperformed the rest of the market, which is actually, and recently only, I think Ethereum has overtaken Ripple again, which Ethereum had taken a back seat. Same thing for, I think EOS is outperforming quite a bit, not as strong as Ethereum, I would say. Right now it is going, Ethereum is really on a big up move. As you all know, that Bitcoin is the real bellwether. I think that's how you know exactly where the market is heading. And we are seeing a lot of consolidation between this $3,800 to $4,000 mark. So it is encouraging, I would say. Again, it's we have talked about it previously. We are way, way away from this 200-day moving average. And that is still, we will call ourselves in bear market. But if you see this pattern, we are seeing this kind of head and shoulder kind of pattern forming out on a daily chart. Again, this is encouraging, and I would say the support levels are around 3,600, 3,700 mark. So that is where I would see as current support levels, and I hope that if this sustains through this period, I'm sure this will give us a lot more positive news. Now, again, we will focus on EOS, and we are going to talk about what's going on in EOS world. So let's go and look at that. So first of all, as I said, this is currently, it's kind of outperformance, but that's always the case. All the other altcoins always outperform Bitcoin in a bull market. Again, I'm not calling it a bull market. I'm saying it's an up move. It's a short term. If you look at an hourly or a kind of a daily move, in recent time, it's a mini bull market right now from the lows of 3,200 area for Bitcoin. And I think if you look at the total market cap, we had around $100 billion. So we are kind of 30% up from there, which is huge in a short time frame. And I would say the Bitcoin EOS, the progress beyond the price, what I would like to see is some of the ideas which I always look at. So let us look at, this is just an example. Now, NewDex is an exchange which integrates a lot of wallets. Now, if you look at it on the right side, when you are in the sign-in page for NewDex, Scatter is, of course, the biggest enabler of EOS, and that's what people use. But look at the number of wallets which have come across, which are integrating. And many of these are mobile wallets, which you can use. I have personally been using quite a few of these wallets. For example, I'm a big fan of MeetOne and especially Token Pocket. I don't know where, this is the Token Pocket wallet. I have been using it. And these wallets are amazing. Like, they give you all this functionality which Scatter provides using your mobile phones. You can play with the dApps, you can play games, you can trade tokens on your mobile. This is only possible in EOS. So this is, again, I'll always look at the bigger picture of what EOS has enabled versus any of the cryptocurrencies out there. So while we look at market cap, while we look at where the market is heading, you need to look at real progress. EOS is only 6 months old. Remember, at the start of 2018, EOS was in ICO. We still had no mainnet. Mainnet came in June. It's like a 6 to 7 months of time frame which has passed. And I'm showing you so many wallets, so many people working on it. This means that there are different ways. There are hundreds of different ways you can interact with EOS. There are so many apps. There are so many wallets. Again, if you go inside this exchange, so let's close this and let's go to the exchange. It's a huge ecosystem. You're seeing the number of tokens here. These are all the projects which are actually functional. Many of them are doing millions of transactions on EOS. And this is something which differentiates EOS with the rest of the chains, rest of the blockchain projects. And this is why I keep reminding you that why EOS is different, why I am so passionate about it, why I see the future of EOS. And the same thing for Ethereum. I think if you look at it, Ethereum is many years old. While the price is going up, and there is an excitement around a lot of new landmarks, Ethereum itself is progressing. But if you look at the pace of development, it is huge. So again, as I keep saying, always remember that you have to look at progress. Markets will keep going up and down. When the bull market starts, everything will go up. I'm sure a lot of people will tell you to buy some tiny token, which is going to go 10 times the value. But that is all about speculation. And of course, you can speculate and make money. It's all about where the real progress is happening and what's investment versus what is you call trading. Okay, now let's go back to investing with a difference. So this is blocks.io. Anybody can see this. This is a public information, investing with a difference account. So I keep reminding people, like, one important thing you need to see when if you are using any block explorer, blocks.io is one of the good ones I always use. You need to look at your RAM usage. So this is one thing which I would like to keep reminding you. Always look at your RAM usage, because there are a lot of dApps which are using your RAM, and never go very close to your full usage. Always buy a little bit. RAM price is pretty low after all the controversy in the early days. Now you see that RAM price is not an issue. CPU is not an issue. If you see, like, every transaction take a few microseconds, and right now for just staking 560 tokens on investing with a difference account, we have 23 second worth of blockchain account, which is huge. So it is right now pretty easy to use CPU. The net, I keep reminding people, do not stake a huge amount of token on net. In fact, 150 tokens here, which we have staked on Investing with a Difference. These were very early on. We were not like really paying attention because we never needed CPU, but actually this 150 is too much. You only need like 5 to 10 EOS. Even if you have thousands of token, you do not need to stake more than 5 to 10 EOS on net. CPU is in, why CPU has come down? We have talked about it in our Telegram channel. So there was a lot of dApps. There were a lot of kind of Ponzi kind of dice games. So people were just mining and creating new dice games were launching every day. There are a lot of hacks, a lot of people who disappeared. The reason is you can just copy paste the code and you can create a dice game. The why they were popular, because you could mine and you can pay dividends. So the miners were making money because they were selling tokens in the market, and the people who were the bag holders like you and me, we were going and buying this in the hope of the dividend. And finally what happened with many of these coins is that you cannot sustain those dividends. The mining went faster and faster, and some examples were Fast Token, which got hacked, Best Token, which went very fast mining. A lot of people got rewards. So there are a lot of innovative ways people are manipulating this. But remember, most of these games have no real innovation beyond just creating this miners to go and automated systems using dice. So be very careful. Look for ideas which are actually creating some new use cases and organic gameplay and not miners. And I think that is what I like about MEV token, which is Royal Online Vegas. And but again, this you are always it's risky to invest in these, as you can see the price is coming down very fast in some of these. Black was another example which was nobody knew. So a lot of these speculations is happening here. A lot of ideas which are people were excited about are like going up and down. But what is happening with the CPU is, now the miners have disappeared, so you have a lot more CPU availability, but still we have millions of transactions happening on blockchain. So this is very exciting. I think this was a good stress test for EOS system. So I'm not disappointed with what happened, but it's a good thing that now people are realizing that it's not a good idea to just keep going off one project after another. And but in what is the lesson for you? The lesson is definitely the CPU is getting better and better. But CPU is still the resource which will be limited in future when the more and more killer apps come. So you want to stake more on CPU. You want to look at how Chintai is going to work. So that is another news. I think I'm sure if you're following some other YouTube channels, you must have seen the Chintai has been continuously improving. It's a great, great tool that is helping the CPU problem. You can rent CPU for very low cost. Same thing for Rex when Rex come around. I believe that Rex is almost ready. We will talk about that when it is going to be available. Similarly, there are a lot of progress happening on the referendum. That is also coming. And so let's look at now the proxy. I think we keep talking about how I think you can make a difference. And you see the Chintai proxy. It at one point, it was like 17 million tokens, because when the CPU was at its worst. Right now, not a lot of people are leasing. It's only 8 million tokens. So it will keep going up and down based on CPU, I believe. But I think, again, so we have 1,739 people proxying with us. And it's a huge thing. I did a video late last year. We talked about how you can keep your proxy updated. So this is another thing you need to focus on. Right now, we still have 6.4% decay, which is not great. So do focus on using your refresh option, auto refresh options. Now it's very easy. And these are the kind of things which are still going to help keep this network participation going ongoing. Now, I keep hearing a lot of people have asked me about the opinion on Brendan Bloomer piece. I have been saying the same thing. He has said that because it cannot be enforced, the vote buying should not be like, you know, looked down upon. It can, we can embrace it. And I believe, I think I have said that before in one of the videos. If you have watched the content we have created all this while, I have been saying that for a very long time already, that only things which can be enforced, they are something we should be worried about. Everything else, it becomes a level playing field if everybody has the same rules. And it's not a big issue, because ultimately, I don't think the votes, we are talking about the 100 million votes which you need. If you look at each block producer in the top, it needs almost 108 million votes to be on the top. And I don't think there can be any significant pay you can give to voters to really gain that many votes. And if you do that, you will anyway not be earning anything. So how it can be a bad thing? If you are trying to benefit from it, and if you're paying everything to voters, then I don't see how you can actually benefit from this reward buying. But yes, I understand there are, like, this is not ideal. We do want to fix that. But it's with Rex, with a lot of other rewards for voting, with the actual genuine voters voting, I think this will keep improving. But at this stage, I think a lot of things, as I said, Chintai Proxy had helped a lot because these are some great block producers running it, and they had been voting and they impacted a lot for some time when the CPU was not that great. But now I think we are seeing a lot more similar block producers who are supported by Waves. They are going and gaining significance all over again. But this keeps moving. Network is still stable, so I'm not too worried about that. So what else is going on? So let's skip over this. I think we have talked about these things a lot earlier. Let's talk about the side chains and sister chains. And we talk about Verbly and Telos. Now, there's a lot of attention being paid because they are trading now. Telos is trading. It started pretty big because of low volumes, as I explained in the one of the videos. So I expected it to fall, which happened. And now it is kind of finding its price around 0.03 EOS, and then we saw some volumes here. Still, the volumes are pretty thin if you look at the daily volume, and we are seeing like less than 20 to 30K on an average. Now, with the 20 to 30K, if you remember, even the whales had up to 40K Telos. So with this low volume, I would not still call it a good price discovery. I don't think a lot of supply is there in the system, but I can see that there is some demand popping up here, and it has gone up quite a bit. Now, one thing which I have been discussing in various forums is trying to understand how the supply will get unlocked. As you know, that Verbly was directly selling the tokens. This has impacted their price negatively, even though they had some demand. But remember that Verbly is actually running a sort of ICO because they're actually selling these tokens in the market. They also did a pre-sale. So that is also, this with the so much supply coming in, with the still the these chains in early stages of implementation, I do not expect the price to run away. A lot of people are speculating on Telos, and I see, because the volume is lower. So remember, Verbly is, I think, 2.5 billion tokens, so it's much more than EOS, but Telos is actually one third the token supply. So that is why I think if Telos is somewhat successful, it will definitely be higher priced. But I think it all depends on how many dApps show up on Telos, how this whole token economics play, because remember, EOS is still backed by Block One. It is, in recent comments, Dan Larimer said that if any sidechain is launched by Block One for a particular application, they will be airdropping to EOS holders. So these are the kind of things which are, I think, very lucrative for EOS investor, while Telos, I think they are trying to do the same model. And I think it is good because it's EOSIO chain, it has a lot of innovation. The question is how the token economics will play. Right now it's all speculation. It's pretty cheap in price. I think it's 0.07 EOS, which is like you can buy quite a lot of Telos for 1 EOS. I think so people are speculating that it can be a good deal, but be careful out there. As I said, the supply can come in anytime, especially because even if you can assume there are like a few thousand 40k accounts, we have not seen that kind of selling which we have seen with some other chains on new decks. So this is something which we will watch out how the price plays out, and this is what happened in the early days of listing, where a lot of selling happened. And also many of these block producers who are producing on Telos and Verbly, they need to sell to survive. So I think there will be always be supply, and I would like to see a lot more demand in terms of volumes. I would like to see much more daily volumes that any big supply sale happening by whales or by block producers, which can be absorbed by the demand. That's when I would say, yes, it's a great investment. So right now, I would be careful. While it's exciting, I think all these sister chains, they have potential, and they can be great investment because they are cheap right now. So there's no harm in buying a little bit. Again, it's not an investment advice. I personally own a little bit of Telos and Verbly. So I would say that please go ahead and if you like it, you can go and invest in it. But I would not be recommending anybody to go and put it in against EOS or consider it as something which can stand against EOS. Remember, EOS is a pretty big market cap coin and it is backed by a lot of VCs. It is backed by Block One, which has a lot of funds, and that's what is the reason the valuation is at that level of billions of dollars. It's not the technology. You can always copy this. Remember what happened with Bitcoin Cash, Bitcoin SV. All these were like kind of forks or of Bitcoin. But again, it's about brand. It's about the recognition in the market. You can always gain some valuation, but you cannot really go and compete with the brand, with the kind of backing with the, which EOS has. So this is one example I would always mention to people. But again, as I said, it is something to be excited about, maybe in case that these chains are able to attract dApps. And both of them we have been supporting, I think, and I think we would like to see more and more such chains, and hopefully this will change the things. Another thing which I think a lot of people have been talking about is what is happening with some of these tokens. I think Tribe has done very innovative model. Tribe has been airdropping for holding tokens, and of course what happens with that is the price slowly keeps going down because a lot more supply comes in. So it's a it's a challenging world for airdropping tokens, but I think Tribe is creating a lot of content and gaining a lot of usage, so which is great. And similar to Tribe, I think Seed did this airdrop, and they keep doing this monthly airdrop just like Tribe, and they are not seeing the same kind of sustained buying. And we saw a big drop in price and on Seed. I think the difference between the two is Seed is still a promise, which is going to be the future of like, you know, the marijuana supply chain and so on, while Tribe is actually seeing real usage. And the and we have talked about both of these projects earlier on. I think a lot of interest has been created by the innovative marketing and the airdropping which these guys have done. You need to be again careful here on how you play out, because this is like you are getting attracted by getting more tokens for the same tokens you hold, but the price of the token is going down. How do you go and make a decision on this? Personally, I would always focus on the progress of the project. While I like the progress of Tribe, I would love to see Seed going in that direction and showing some progress on real project, while the right now the token economics has played out. And I hope that this will become a more real project, because I really support medical marijuana, because it's been proven too that it can really help a lot of patients of diseases which are like with the painkillers are really killing your bodies. The kind of things which the pharma companies use, they're addictive, they're causing a lot of issues. And I have seen, like I've talked to a lot of doctors who support this medical marijuana. So I hope that blockchain and medical marijuana supply chain and the kind of project which Seed is trying to develop, it gets is successful for the sake of humanity, which needs these kind of solutions. But again, it's a matter of project execution. So all these projects, I would say, be careful out there. Another coin I think which I was excited about is Infiniverse. I have been using this their app, and this token again went up and now it's going down a bit. And this was again when they launched. They have launched an app. A lot of progress is happening in Infiniverse, because what they're doing is you can have virtual land, which is the actual coordinates on the earth. And you can place objects, you can actually own that piece of land, you can create 3D objects and so on. It's a very interesting project. I would recommend you to go check it out. Again, a lot of big, it's pretty good communities forming around Infiniverse. I interacted with their Telegram channel and I was very encouraged the way things are happening. We have been, I think, talking about Horus Pay, we are talking about Karma and a lot of other projects. I think I'm sure if you're following other YouTube channels, you are getting a lot of information about them. EOS DAC is another thing which I would like to talk about, as this is something which is one of the block producers. They are also, EOS DAC is a kind of a it's a decentralized community, which is kind of you can participate, anybody is openly, you can discuss the issues, they have worker proposal systems. They have custodian voting going on, as I have explained earlier. I'm one of the candidates for custodian, so if you like it, if you like the work we do and the thought process we have, I want to bring the same thing for EOS DAC, bringing investor perspective and how these DACs can run, bringing an value to EOS DAC. I think what I can add value as is by creating, you know, how to create the token valuable, how to create the project valuable based on my experience with startups, with early stage companies. EOS DAC is nothing but that. And that's where I'm hoping that we can create value there. But again, as I said, I believe in decentralization. I believe in decentralized communities. So EOS DAC is a great example. And one more thing which I love about EOS DAC is they're creating a platform where you can actually launch more DACs. And that is something which is very exciting. You can actually keep using that platform. People can airdrop tokens through EOS DAC and create a model of the DAC model, as you can call it, where things are run in a decentralized way. And you can, anything can be decentralized using this DAC model. And that's the goal of EOS DAC, and I'm very excited about that. So while I think a lot of you have been looking at, I think 80% of the people and the volumes on new DAX has been on the betting or gambling games, I wanted to highlight all these great projects which are happening in parallel. That is something, and Higher Vibes, I think, another one which we had talked about previously, so just wanted to cover that. It's kind of stabilized after the hack they faced and so on. Boyd, the decentralized computing, this has been doing pretty well. It had seen a lot of interest recently. The token price again keeps going up and down, but I hear a lot of people are mining Boyd and they're using the decentralized computing. So there are many, many projects which are actually seeing progress, actual people investing into it. Then Challenge dApp, as you all know, I think a lot of people follow Kent and his channel. So this is making some progress recently, I heard. And so similarly, like Edna, I think this is another project which is doing pretty well, getting a lot of attention from people. These are all great ideas. Sports betting, I think ESB, this is a sports betting. I think they have recently launched with the latest games and so on. So a lot of progress happening in all these projects, and I'm not worried about the bear market. We are always kept talking about it. So it was amazing year. If you look at all these projects, if you look at what is happening in EOS in terms of actual projects gaining adoption, a lot of communities getting formed, and I think $2.90, even though it looks low, remember that we started in ICO with like 50 cents below in late 2017, when market was peaking, when Bitcoin was like going up $10,000, $20,000, and EOS was just starting. Now it's only 6 months into mainnet, and I talked about so many different projects. I would say that it's still early days. We need 2019 can be a huge year, and that is what we are looking forward to. This is what I like, because ultimately it's a usable chain, whether it was gambling apps which tested it, whether it was block Twitter spamming. We have hit records. We have done amazing amount of blockchain activity, which EOS has given. And we are already seeing sister chains coming. We are already seeing EOS IEO ecosystem expanding. So the possibilities are limitless how you can really gain acceptance of this EOS software. And Block One has not even launched any major app. So this is like what can happen with EOS is amazing. Same thing for Bitcoin, I would say. I'm pretty excited about where the things are heading. I see a lot more acceptance. I see governments saying that there are a lot of state governments in US who are accepting payments now in Bitcoin. I see a lot more acceptance of Bitcoin in many, many different forums. So there's actual progress happening while speculation has reduced. There is less talk of hitting $100,000 or $1 million. All those are speculation. The price speculation is something which people love to do, because that's what drives kind of a hype. We are looking for like some institutional interest coming in the Bitcoin world. We are seeing the BAKKT, B-A-A-K-K-T, I think that's where the acronym is. I don't know exactly what it stands for, but basic idea is that you will have a lot more financial instruments from institutional investors where they can bring in a lot more funds into the cryptocurrencies. So I think, again, the cryptocurrency part of it, that the EOS as a token price and Bitcoin as a token price, nobody knows when we will recover, where is the bottom. What we can see is 2018 was an year where we saw progress, we saw actual things changing on the ground. 2019 can use that platform from 2018 and we can really take off And I'm talking about adoption, I'm not talking about price. Price will follow one day. It's all about whether was it a hype? Was it just a kind of a short-term fad? Or the blockchain and the projects are here to stay? That's what we need to figure out. And that's what I'm here to talk about. And what I talked about in this video, we talked about so many projects on EOS. The reason I really believe in EOS, I don't think you can spend more than 5 minutes talking about what is happening in other projects like Bitcoin Cash, Ripple. I don't know what's really happening there. I think Ethereum, I'm seeing a renewed interest in that. Again, it means I'm not a great fan of Ethereum because of the limitations it has and because of the lack of progress. But I think what I really love about Ethereum is the kind of communities which it has formed. And that is what is strong, and that's why it is keeping Ethereum alive. But again, as I said, EOS is where I see most progress happening. I'm seeing some good stuff happening in Stellar and Litecoin because they are anyway low market cap. But I would still say that they are nowhere close to the kind of communities EOS is building. And I have that's why I have dedicated most of my time on EOS. And that is something which I keep talking about. So I hope this was a great good discussion. I hope you like the content. Do send us your feedback. Again, I will keep reminding you that my goal is to bring a view which perhaps you will not get in the EOS world, because I'm not planning to do a lot more tutorials or day-to-day news kind of a videos in EOS world, because as I keep reminding you, that this was never the intention for this channel. And our goal was to bring perspectives, bring views of how you should analyze the news rather than what is the news. So do send us your feedback, ask us your question. Again, I keep reminding you to join our Telegram channel where I'm very much active. This is the link right here on the small link. You see the Telegram logo. That's where we do a lot more discussions on a day-to-day basis about smaller topics, which I may not be able to cover always in the videos. And feel free to send us messages, comments on the YouTube video itself. We try to read all the comments. In fact, I definitely read each and every comment and try to reply as many as we can. So do that. And again, wishing you a very happy new year. Wish everybody that the markets turn out, because ultimately all of us are investors. All of us hold these coins which we have invested in, and of course we want to see profits while we believe in this great technology which is unfolding in front of our eyes. So hope that it turns around, but if it does not, just follow the progress, just follow where the things are heading, and be aware and keep your eyes open, because things change very fast. I will be the first one to come back and tell you if things are going south in any of these markets like EOS or any other markets. As I said, Ethereum, I was the one who talked about in very early on in this channel. In June, I talked about Ethereum when it was at almost, I think, $800 to $1,000, that Ethereum is not going to do well and the price will go down. I did not know that the rest of the market will go that bad, but definitely I knew that Ethereum will underperform, and that's what happened. I think it's kind of hit the bottom now. Ethereum is recovering, so I would be the first one to come back and tell you when EOS is not doing as well as I expect. I will be the first one to tell you if Bitcoin is not progressing the way it is. But today, so disclaimer again, this is not financial advice, but personally I do hold Ethereum a little bit, but mostly Bitcoin and EOS, and these are the two projects I really believe in, and I closely watch the progress on both of these projects, and specifically on EOS, because this is a real platform. While cryptocurrencies are sometimes mostly speculation, the blockchain platforms like Ethereum and EOS, they are here to stay. And the most progress I see today is in EOS world, and I'm very happy with 6 months or 7 months of mainnet which we have seen. And I think by next year, this time when we are reviewing the 2019, we may have a totally different picture, because if the progress which has happened in last 6 months is anything to go by, I would not be surprised if this channel is just a very small piece of huge media around EOS, huge communities around EOS, and I'm sure there will be much bigger channels, there will be much more content out there, and I would not be unhappy if this channel gets lost out in that race, because as I keep reminding you, my original goal was just to make sure that people are aware of what's going on and bringing a perspective, and we have successfully done that, and thanks a lot for all your love. While I say that, we are not stopping the content, we'll keep bringing the content, but it will be slightly of different kind, talking about perspectives and understanding the things rather than giving you some facts or tutorials around EOS. Thanks once again for all your love. We'll wait for your feedback on this video and all the other content we produce. Thank you. Bye-bye.